So this is going to be Carob's Valentine's themed cage tour. And before we get started with the tour, I wanted to just briefly mention a quick change that I have been working on. You might notice the habitrail ovotube that is leading down into her cage. And there is a cap on it at the moment, so she can't go up in it because I'm still finishing up. But you'll notice there are two habitrail ovopods above her cage. And then there are some tubes leading to the left. And that is actually going to connect on to the 8-foot tank. So she will have both habitats to go back and forth between. The tank I'm going to be decorating natural with some wooden toys and some deeper substrate that she can burrow in. I just thought I would mention that for those of you who are new to my channel and you see this cage and you think that perhaps she would, you know, benefit with some wooden toys. She is going to have it. It's going to be connected on in another cage. So we'll go ahead and get started with this particular tour now. In the front left of the cage, she has this heart-shaped food dish, and this is something that I found at Goodwill. I have a lot of success at Goodwill finding differently shaped dishes. And this is just sitting on top of a Super Pet waffle block from a waffle block house. And little Miss Carob just loves to eat. She always runs to the food dish immediately whenever I put food in. And she does have a tendency to hoard as well. Next to that is this cardboard little mailbox, which actually has a Valentine in it that I made myself with non-toxic markers. So this cardboard mailbox, I'm trying to remember where I got it from and I'm completely drawing a blank, but I know it was either Walmart or Dollar Tree. On the far right side, there is another ceramic dish which also has sand in it, and she pees in both of these. It's kind of funny. I found this one at Goodwill as well. So on the right side, you can see these paper straws, which Taxonomous actually gave me this idea of doing this, and I thought that is such a great idea because it's literally just rolled up paper. And I cut some heart shapes on the top and I glued those up there. Near that, there is a heart-shaped ceramic dish, and in the dish I have a bunch of different types of chews and a rice pop, which she was trying to eat the whole thing all at one time, so I did actually have to take it out after she had some nibbles of it, but it's just super cute. Alright, so moving along to the front right corner. This is a paper bucket that I found at Walmart. I actually remember that one. And I think it was 98 cents, and I basically just cut a little hole for the doorway for her to go in. And I flipped it upside down, and she has fun going in that little bucket. It's a great size for Syrian hamsters. And then in the middle of the cage, you probably noticed this box with a really pretty heart design on it. And this is something that I found at Walmart, and it was supposed to be a photo box. So originally it had like this little metal thing on it. I really actually don't know what they're called, but I pulled off the metal piece because I didn't want her to chew on it. And then I took the lid off the box, flipped it upside down, and put the lid on the bottom of the box, if that makes sense. So basically the underneath is completely open and she's able to like burrow. And I cut a hole for the doorway on the left side, and then on the right side I cut another hole and I stuck this pink igloo through it. So she has like a little nest inside of a nest, and she loves this box. This is where she sleeps in here. I think it was around $2 or $3, which is not bad, And it's really cute for Valentine's Day cage theme, so just throwing that idea out there for those of you who want to go pick up something to decorate your hamster's cage with, but just make sure that you take the metal piece off of the box.